left below.
Ooh, a He Is Risen production.
Rapture?
Oh, Mr. Thompson. What if your wife finds out?
It's modern times. Everyone's doing it. Where did my Christian limo driver go?
My pious husband is missing.
The baby I chose to have baptized is gone. Mr. Thompson, what's happening?
It's the rapture, Shauna. The rapture. The virtuous have gone to heaven, and the rest of us have been left below.
Hello everyone, it's End Times Talk coming at you with a brand new video. This one's going to be really cool because we get to talk more about the pre-tribulation rapture, and it's a subject that I'm truly passionate about. On my channel's main page, there's a playlist page, all right? And on that page, there is a playlist about evidence for a pre-tribulation rapture that is quite lengthy. And it's older videos that I've made, and one day I do plan on putting everything into one video and making like a feature-length film. But today I wanted to present some more of the evidence that I've been kind of holding back and taking some time on and looking into it. I want to be able to present that to you today. Anyways, you know, all throughout TV shows, they are pushing this agenda of a mass disappearance of people. I mean, I'm pretty positive, and I think it's pretty safe to assume that the governments know that a pre-tribulation rapture is coming, because there's all these propaganda pieces out there, you know, pushing this idea of a mass disappearance of people. There is a new television show, and it's not the old War of the Worlds with Tom Cruise that was made by Steven Spielberg. It's not the radio show that was done by Orson Welles, the War of the Worlds, but there is a War of the Worlds television show, not the one that's the Wild Wild West War of the Worlds, okay, where there's like cowboys and stuff like that. But I'm talking about the one where they're over in Europe, and in this, there's an electromagnetic pulse that happens that absolutely wipes out the planet. I mean, it wipes out the planet. And I mean, everybody's gone. Everybody's gone. I think it's kind of interesting that they push that electromagnetic pulse stuff so hard, because I truly believe in my spirit. I truly believe this in my spirit, that when Jesus raptures the saints off this earth, that there's so much energy and there's so much force and there's so much power. When God does this, that it just shuts the world down, that it just completely collapses the grid. You know, the world can't take it. I mean, if we can't stand in the presence of God, how is the world, the evil world, this dark world, going to stand Jesus coming and taking us home? All right. I truly believe that it's going to cause some form of a blackout. All right. And it's going to set the world back. All right. Everything's boom, going to go dark just like that. And I'm telling you right now, that's what I truly believe is going to begin the 3 days of darkness. That's just my opinion. Okay, I truly believe the 3 days of darkness is coming after the rapture, but I believe it's going to happen right after the rapture. All right, that's just my idea. That's just my thought. That's just my theory. Okay, anyways, there's different platforms that they present propaganda to us on to be able to condition us to believe things the way they want us to believe in the future. There's television, there's movies, there's music videos, there's books and literature and news and all this different stuff. Okay, but also a lot of people forget a certain platform that a lot of people are involved in, and it's absolutely going unnoticed, and it is comic books. All right, comic books. There is this comic book, all right, that was written by a man named Robert Kirkman, the man that brought you the most famous television show on the planet, known as The Walking Dead, wrote a comic book, and this is a bit, it's being adapted to a movie. Okay, and it's being directed by Jake Gyllenhaal. Okay. And it's interesting because he's in a lot of movies. I think he's pretty well, it's pretty well safe to say that as popular as he is, the way they choose him in movies, he's been illuminated per se. All right, I truly think that. I don't trust Jake Gyllenhaal, but I think he's one of those people that's, you know, being used to help condition people, you know, for what's to come, especially with that new movie that he's going to be coming out with called The Division, and how money has a virus on it and they got to have a digital currency because money makes everybody sick. You know, there's a lot of propaganda in the movies that he's pushing right now. In an Oblivion Song is about a man, all right, that developed a device that it was like an electromagnetic pulse device, all right, and it opened a portal in the city of Philadelphia and swallowed a good chunk of the city. And supposedly all these people have been taken. All these people are gone that are part of the area of Philadelphia that's been swallowed by Oblivion. And Oblivion, I mean, look at the symbol there. It's the infinity symbol. You have the infinity 8 symbol right there. And that's also symbolic of Oblivion. Oblivion, I think, is another way we could say hell. Okay. It's another dimension. It's Oblivion. All right. Anyways, this man, created this electromagnetic pulse machine, all right, and it caused a portal to open up and swallow, like I said, a good chunk of Philadelphia. All these people have been lost into Oblivion, and even in the real world, that's the people who are not in Oblivion, the people who are mourning the loss of the people who are lost into Oblivion, they have a monument even that they've resurrected with all these names of all these people that have gone missing, all right? I mean, all throughout movies, music, literature, TV, media, they're telling us about mass disappearances of people. Why is it that all alien movies, I mean, especially like Skyline, in the beginning of that Skyline movie, I mean, tons of people are getting sucked up into the air by these ships. I mean, thousands and thousands of people, probably hundreds of thousands of people.
I can't see. Is that what I think it is?
It's absolutely crazy that how hard they're pushing this agenda of people being snatched up off the earth. Well, you want to know why? It's because the Illuminati knows that there's going to be a pre-tribulation rapture. And I was told this by my buddy who was ex-Illuminati, and he was taught this by people who, when he was in the Illuminati, that they do expect a pre-tribulation rapture. They are terrified of it. He said that it is the one event that they're truly not prepared for, but they're doing their best to try to cover it up. You can't stop God. God is too powerful, he's too mighty, and there's no way that you can stop the advance of God's kingdom to come, and that's just plain and simple, right? Promise you that. I'll promise you that. But I will tell you that the Illuminati does have plans to try to either halt the rapture or there to be a sort of false flag rapture event before the real rapture, and I want, my job as End Times Talk is to warn Christians, all right? It's to warn the sinners. It's to warn the sinners that you need Jesus, all right? We all need Jesus. And it's to warn the Christians to turn back to your King and to repent. But it's also to warn Christians of not to be deceived of the things that are coming ahead. And wouldn't it be great? Wouldn't it be great if Satan could create a fake rapture to trick Christians into believing they've been left behind? Think about that, folks. Think about that. They got the neutron bomb where it can literally destroy biological matter but leave everything else intact. What if one of those went off somewhere, or what if multiple ones went off somewhere and wiped everybody out, killed everybody, and it looked like a rapture event, all right? And all these people were just gone, just zapped gone, all right? But yet, all the infrastructure, all the buildings, all the cars, all the traffic lights, all the stop signs, all the quickie marts and the 7-Elevens and all that stuff are still going, and all the food's still on the shelves, but all the people are gone. All the dogs are gone. All the animals are gone because biological matter is zapped. All right. I truly believe that it's possible. And I also believe that when you take the mark of the beast, that inside of that, they've developed a little itty bitty miniature cyanide capsule that when you disobey and you aren't doing what you're supposed to be doing in the beast system, those of the people who take the mark of the beast, I believe they can kill you on the spot if you don't toe the line. If they did a mass number of people all at once, it could look like some form of rapture event, okay? Illuminati has plans to cover up the rapture, or they have plans to have a false flag rapture. And this Illuminati card right here proves it. When the rapture comes, see, they know what's coming. When the rapture comes, I'll make them wait. They'll never clean my cage, and I'll give them some more of ... Tape runs out. Good try. Too bad something went wrong. And look at that. You have the real. It's almost like the real ends to life. Okay? It's almost like time runs out. The real ends. The tape snaps up back to the reals. You see what I'm saying? God's snapping his people back up, and then the earth is splitting in two because the earth is sent into chaos because of the rapture. Look at that, people. And they have plans to cover it up. That's why they're saying, good try. Too bad something went wrong. And that's why it says, I'll make them wait. All right. But they know, it says, when the rapture comes. They know. Breaking this down. Look at that. Right there. The Illuminati knows the rapture's coming. I really want you to get that into your head. Now, the Illuminati has another card that's out there. All right. This one's called the Church of Middle America. It says, they'll never get it, even when the saucers are flying overhead. Now, I really want you to look at that picture there. What is the Church of Middle America? All right. What is the Church of Middle America? It's the Bible Belt. All right. That is what that is talking about. The Bible Belt in America. The Church of Middle America. Not the Church of Afghanistan. Not the Church of Kuwait. This is the Church of Middle America. Not the West. Not the East. Middle America. So it's talking about the Bible Belt. Out of all the denominations of Christianity, okay, what is the Bible Belt most known for? It's Baptist, okay? And I love Baptists. I love Baptists. Absolutely love them. But there are some Baptists who are cessationists, and they believe the gifts of the Spirit have ceased, okay? And some people believe that are cessationists believe that God is not going to rapture people, that we're going to go through the Great Tribulation, all right? And after the people have been taken, all right, just like in all the other movies, and the saucers are flying overhead, those people who are stubborn, they still won't get it. The Church of Middle America still won't get it, because I believe you have to believe in the rapture to go. You have to believe in the rapture. You have to be watching and waiting for the rapture. Malachi chapter 3 verse 16 states, then they that feared the Lord spoke often to one another. So those that loved the Lord, that feared the Lord, that had reverence for the Lord, spoke often one to another about the Lord, and the Lord hearkened and heard it. And a book of remembrance was written before him for them that feared the Lord and that thought upon his name. And they shall be mine, saith the Lord of hosts, in that day when I make up my jewels. And actually, that jewel word there could also mean crown or treasure. Okay. When I make up my jewels, and I will spare them as a man spareth his own son that serves him. Spare them from what? Spare them from the Great Tribulation. So it's saying right here in the Old Testament, the criteria to be in the rapture has, you have to be written in the book of remembrance, and you have to be someone that fears the Lord, speaks often to one another about the Lord. All right. And then the Lord hearkens and hears that. And so what that means is, and that's more of a simple form of saying, you need to be an active Christian. You need to be witnessing. You need to be teaching. You need to be speaking about God. If you're just sitting at home and you're idle and you only go to church one day a week on a day that's not even the true Sabbath, and then you go out and you sin the next week and you just commit all these sins and you just keep living your life however you want to live it, and then you just go back one day more and say your I'm sorries to God, that's not true Christian living, all right? Christian living is getting active, going out there, witnessing, preaching, and teaching, warning people of what's to come, telling people about the blood of Jesus Christ, people who already have the blood of Jesus Christ, educating them about the more deeper things of God, to never be done doing the Lord's work. There are so many people who are like, oh, I'm ready to go home. I'm ready to go home. And you know what? We all are, but we have a job to do, my brothers and sisters. We have a job to do. And every hour, God waits. More and more people are being saved. If God was to snatch us up right now, all right, so many people would be lost. We have work to do. Doesn't mean that the rapture's not going to happen tomorrow, but I honestly think sometimes that God's waiting on us to do our job. Just like the master was waiting on the servants to do the job that he gave them to do, and that was to invest what God has given him while he was gone. So we need to be investing what God has given us, and that is the precious Holy Spirit and the anointing of the Holy Spirit and the precious blood of Jesus Christ that saves from all sin. All right, that gives us eternal life. That is something we need to stand on, that foundation. We need to stand on it, stand tall, and shout it from the rooftops, people, because it is our job. It is the commission that God has given us to go out and preach the gospel and to make disciples out of all men and women. All right, out of all men and women, that is the commission that our King has given us, okay? And we have to be about our Father's business, just like Jesus was. Jesus was about his Father's business in the temple. We need to be about our Father's business now until he comes and gets us, all right? That is what it is. It also says right here in Zephaniah chapter 2, verses 1 through 3, it says, "Gather yourselves together, yea, gather together, O nation, not desired, before the decree, bring forth before the day. Bring forth before the day passes the chaff, before the fierce anger of the Lord come upon you, before the day of the Lord's anger come upon you. Seek ye the Lord, all ye meek of the earth, which have wrought his judgment. Seek righteousness, seek meekness, that it may be ye shall be hid in the day of the Lord's anger." Once again, we have God telling us in Zephaniah in the Old Testament that he plans to spare us from the Lord's anger, the day of the Lord's anger, the great tribulation, the time of Jacob's trouble, all right? Over and over again, all throughout the Bible, if you quit adding your opinions and your biases to the Bible and you read it for what it is, he is telling us that he wants us to be in alignment with him so we're ready to go with him because we are the bride of Christ. All right, that is what's going on, people. That is what's going on. And the Illuminati knows. The Illuminati knows that Jesus means serious business. And they put cards out there like that. And they put comic books out there like that. And they put movies out there like Skyline and Close Encounters of the Third Kind and all these alien movies where they're sucking people up into these spaceships. All these TV shows about mass disappearances of people, like the new War of the Worlds TV show. All right. I mean, it goes on and on and on. The propaganda that's being pushed on us to make us think to basically cover up the rapture. That's what's going on. They want to cover up the rapture. They want to have every angle covered that they can. If aliens aren't going to work, they sure want to say that a portal opened up and swallowed us up. All right. I mean, look at that movie, and I do not suggest watching it. It is very graphic, and I did not know it when I first watched it. But that movie Annihilation is all about them opening portals to other worlds, and it's very graphic. Do not watch it as a Christian. All right. It will trouble you, I promise. All right. Very troubling movie. And what I'm trying to say, though, is that they're making this stuff. They want multiple explanations. There is a movie out there that was made back in the early 2000s that was called Vanishing on 7th Street. And it is a mirror image of what the rapture is. And then after all these people disappear, these demons start taking over people. And then if you actually watch the movie, which is on YouTube, I, as a Christian, you need to ask the Lord what, if you need to watch that movie or not, because it is, there's some areas of it that are a little graphic. It's not 100% bad, but there's a lot of push in that Hollywood is doing, and that's why I think some people who are more mature Christians should see a movie like that to be able to warn other Christians of what the agenda is. But for those of you who don't want to watch the movie, I'm going to show you a trailer of the movie. Check this video out.
Yesterday's.
And I've showed this clip before, but people need to see they're pushing this agenda. They're pushing this agenda of a mass disappearance of people. And then look, in Vanishing on 7th Street, there's all this darkness that starts to take over and the daylight quits coming back for a period of time. All right, just like people are talking about this 3 days of darkness. So I wonder, and it is my theory, all right, this is not biblical or anything like that. It's just a theory of mine that when Jesus comes back, there's so much power and strength and might and authority with him, okay, that it just wipes out the Earth's electrical grid when his power snatches us up off the planet, all right? Think of the energy it's going to take to globally snatch people up off the planet, all right? So I truly believe it's going to cause a blackout, and then that's when I believe that they're not going to know what to do. All right, and it's going to cause that 3 days of darkness, and the demons are going to finally begin to have their time on this earth, and peace will be taken from the earth because the restrainer, the Holy Spirit, the anointing of God on this earth, the one who draws us unto Jesus Christ, will be taken off the earth, and the people will be left to suffer. Now, I'm not saying there's not going to be Christians after the rapture and that people aren't going to realize, well, I guess the Christians were right the whole entire time. Those people that were crazy and saying that the pre-tribulation rapture is coming and that God could actually care to save his people, all right, from the great tribulation, all right? Those people that are left behind that are the naysayers and the people who have denied the power of God. It says that in the end times they shall have a form of godliness, but they shall deny God's power, all right? And that is a part of what I'm talking about. These people who deny God's power will be left behind, and they will be left behind to suffer, but they will come to God. And I believe that they'll be true converts because they're not going to give in, because they're going to know that they got to keep going until their time comes, all right? There's people that will make it through the Great Tribulation. I truly believe it, but many will be killed in the process. All right, and then it says in the Bible the Antichrist will make war with the Christians. So let's not be left on this earth. Let's be about the Father's business now. Let's get our lives right now. Repent. Every single one of you are struggling with something. I know I got my struggles. All right, I know I got my 2x4 in my eye. All right, all right. Let's all pull these things out together and let's say, let's repent. Let's have a day of repentance. Every single one of you who is watching this video, who has a troubled heart and a heavy heart and all this extra weight of the world that is on your back, all the things you're struggling with, all the problems you have, all the worries you have about the family members who aren't saved and all the heartbreak you've had and all the relationships that have been broken and all the losses you've had and the sickness in the family that you've been struggling with and the sickness you've been struggling with. Let's just give it all to God right now. Let's pray right now and let's all repent right now. Let's do this right now. In Jesus' name we pray. We come to you in all authority in the blood of Jesus Christ. And we just thank you, God, for saving us from our sins. We thank you for being there for us. We thank you for loving us. But we ask you, Jesus, to once again forgive us of our sins. As I lead this prayer before all these people that I know are praying with me, we repent of our sins, God. We repent for the sins of this nation. We ask you, God, to heal us, to heal our land, to heal our families, to heal our households, to fix all the things that are broken, Jesus. Fix all the things that Satan has broken. Fix all the things that we have broken, God. Fix all the things that we have destroyed by our own hands, by our own admission, by our own doings, Lord. We ask you to wash that away, Jesus, with your precious blood, Lord. We ask for your anointing to come from heaven and to bless each and every single one of these people watching, Lord. I pray for an anointing over their lives, God, and an anointing of the Holy Spirit, the power of God that's so strong in their life that they will confirm the word of God with the anointing of God, and they will go forth preaching and to teach, and that they will go forth showing signs and wonders to confirm that God is good and that God loves his people and that God is sparing his people from judgment. In Jesus' name, I just pray for peace over every mind that's out there, every mind that has turmoil, every mind that has fear, every mind that has worry and anxiety in Jesus' mighty name. I rebuke it in Jesus' mighty name. And I pray the blood of Jesus Christ over their mind from the tops of their head to the soles of their feet, Lord. And I just ask you, Jesus, just to bless them, Lord. Bless their finances. Bless their health, Lord. Bless their speech, Lord, that their speech is anointed, that they can go out and speak with the boldness of lions, Lord. I pray for your glory to shine through, Lord, that we don't get any credit, that you get all the glory, God. All glory be to God in all forms and every single way. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, the one who was, who is to come. The Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We thank you, Jesus, not just for what you do for us, but for who you are. And we ask you, Jesus, if you're in need of anything, Lord. Lord, do you need anything from us? Will you show us what you need, Lord? Will you show us how to minister to you, how to love you better, Lord? Teach us how to be more open to you. Help our hearts unfold like a flower before you, Lord. And we just ask you to peel back the petals, Jesus. And we give you all access to every room in our heart that we've held back from you, God, right now in this moment. We give you the master key, Lord. And we just ask you to go inside of us and clean us out as we repent, Lord, as we repent of our sins. God, forgive us. Jesus, forgive us of our sins, Lord. We're so, so sorry for what we've done. And we just ask you to bless us, bless our families, bless the generations that come after us, Lord. And we just thank you, Jesus, for your mighty, precious sacrifice on that cross. And we lay all our problems and all our worries and all our woes and all our fears and anxieties down at the foot of that cross. And we stand up and we thank you, Jesus. And we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Now, I want you guys to go out and preach, teach, and love your brothers and your sisters. Love your neighbors. Love your enemies. Be as wise as serpents, but as harmless as doves. May God bless you, may God keep you, and don't forget to go out and change the world in which you live.